heat resistant?
Yeah, I do competitive ice dancing.
It's what they use on the space shuttle to prevent it from burning up on re-entry.
I do very competitive ice dancing.
Hey everybody, this is going to be my Justice League post-credits video. Just careful for spoilers if you haven't seen it yet, because we'll be talking about specific things in the future of the DCEU. The first post-credits scene is probably the most comic booky one, even though the second one is the most world-building one. And I think that it's also part of the way that they changed the end of the movie. I don't think they originally intended for that to be that post-credits scene. I think originally they were intending on setting up some more direct Darkseid stuff, but I'll address that when I do my deleted scenes video. This'll just be for the actual stuff from the movie. The Flash racing Superman just felt like the greatest thing ever. Obviously, it's a follow-up to a couple of preceding moments in the film, like the moment where Superman is able to turn his head while they're all fighting each other, like just to show you how badass he is, and makes Flash crap his pants. Then later during the big final battle when Superman just flies up right next to Flash while they're trying to save people as fast as possible. So you just get that tease like, wow, I wonder which one of these guys is faster. If you're a big comic book fan, you know that the Flash can be faster. This post-credit scene is more of a reference to the first time that they legit had a race in the comics. And the whole reason for that was because they were trying to raise money for charity. It wound up being a tie. So there's just a couple tweaks for the stuff that happened during the movie just to give it a little sense of continuity. But I love the idea. Like, Superman has been around for a while. He has to tell Flash which way the West Coast is. Sorry, buddy, it's that way. The first one was from Superman Volume 1, number 199 in 1967. Then there were a couple follow-up issues to that specific race where they raced each other through outer space. Don't ask me how he did it, but because the Silver Age comics were a little bit sillier, Flash comics in particular at that time, he was able to actually run in the vacuum of space. Typically what would happen is that crazy stuff would happen during the race that would cause them to change positions. They would have to defeat villains, but it usually wound up being a tie. The thing is more recently in the Rebirth comics, where Superman is racing against Wally, Wally tells him, "You remember all those times we ran against each other? I was taking it easy on you that whole time," just kind of blowing your mind like, oh wow, I guess the Flash has always been faster than Superman. The thing about the movie, though, is that this version of the Flash is still brand new. He's like a baby Flash. Superman has been around the block, so that's why he seems so much more OP than what the Flash would be like were he at his full power. But obviously, they'll address that during the Flashpoint movie. Like, you'll just see that character develop through the next Justice League film. The second post-credit scene was really what drove people crazy. I went to see it with a bunch of other comic book YouTubers. You may have seen us posting pictures from the premiere. When we got to that Deathstroke moment, they almost fell out of their chairs. It was great. It was probably one of the most fun things about the premiere, aside from watching the movie itself. What they're telling you, obviously, is that Lex Luthor hired Deathstroke to bust him out of prison, and then he says, you know, like once he's sitting on his big mega yacht there, it's time we had a league of our own, meaning that they're doing Injustice League in the movies. The original Injustice League in the comics has already been retconned, but like the original Silver Age iteration is basically this alien Agamemno contacting Lex Luthor and telling him to form a team so that they can face the Justice League for the amusement of these aliens. Like, it's a bored alien who says, hey, you know what? I want to see the heroes fight the villains. So he contacts Lex Luthor, but it started out as Lex Luthor, Black Manta, Kronos, Catwoman, Dr. Light, the male Dr. Light, Felix Faust, Mr. Element, the Penguin, and Sinestro. But like I said, the comics retconned the original roster, so the extra characters that got added to the original team were the Joker, Deathstroke, the Key, Bane, Bizarro, Harley Quinn, Poison Ivy, Scarecrow, Two-Face, and Reverse Flash. So in terms of movie roster, the only thing we know is that Deathstroke and Lex Luthor are on the team. Obviously, they'll grab some of the big A-list Batman characters that we've probably seen so far. Maybe Harley Quinn, maybe the Joker. It depends on how much Joker they want to use. Here's the real big thing, though. You may have heard about how they changed the ending of the movie to make it a little more self-contained. Like, originally, it was going to be part one of a two-part Darkseid story. You take down Steppenwolf at the end, and you get the reveal of Darkseid, and he becomes the big bad of the second Justice League movie. So what I think they've done now is they've opted for more human, more identifiable villains, and that's why they're pushing Injustice League, and they'll do them as the antagonists of the next Justice League film, not Darkseid. They haven't confirmed anything about what's going on with that next Justice League film other than they're working on it, and it's all speculation at this point as to what the story is going to be. But it just sounds like you don't tee up something like Injustice League Deathstroke, Lex Luthor out and about without following up on it in relatively short order. So I don't think they're going to be too involved with the Flashpoint movie. Maybe some Easter eggs because of the way people's alignments shift during Flashpoint. Like, you get to see some of the villains be good characters and some of the heroes be bad characters. So don't worry about that too much right now. But I think it's so awesome that Joe Manganiello still gets to be Deathstroke. And this sort of backs up the idea about what's going on with the Deathstroke movie. Originally, people were like, oh my God, is he not going to be in that Matt Reeves Batman film? Because the whole script was all about Deathstroke versus Batman, and they threw that out. That was the Geoff Johns Ben Affleck script. But then people started asking him, are you still in the DC movies? Are you still going to play the Deathstroke character? And he's like, I don't know. And obviously, he had a big discretionary bonus. That's the money that they pay actors for keeping their mouths shut about big spoilers until movies come out. So in the next couple of weeks, you'll probably hear Joe Manganiello talking more about being Deathstroke, just because they stuck him in at the end of Justice League. So I think that was all sort of a late addition to the movie, because they're like, we really want to have him play Deathstroke, and we want to do this Deathstroke spinoff movie, so maybe there's a way that we can pull back on real big cosmic villains and do something a little more human. Bam, in Justice League. And we can have Deathstroke bust Lex Luthor out of prison. So the logic makes sense. Deathstroke would do something like that. Lex Luthor has an infinite amount of money, so of course he's going to hire the world's best to bust him out. And if they wanted to, they could actually do an Injustice League spin-off film. Like, they would do Suicide Squad, a movie about villains doing good things. Injustice League would be a movie about villains doing very bad things. So let me know in the comments, now that they've teased that, do you actually want to see them do Injustice League in the next Justice League movie, or do you just want to see a spin-off film with those characters like Deathstroke, Lex Luthor, and anybody else that they would add to their team? The really cool thing that you may have spotted, you know, because he has the full bald head, they shaved it at the end of Batman v Superman, he's also wearing a suit that looks just like Gene Hackman's suit in the 1978 Superman film. So it's like them saying, we're going full comic book with this. However you feel about Jesse Eisenberg's portrayal of the character, I know it's very polarizing, but I just love the extra touches that they added to that moment. But what'll happen is I'll post my spoilery review of the movie tomorrow, then I'll start doing Easter egg videos over the weekend, so make sure you go see it when you have the chance. I'm still doing that movie ticket giveaway. All you have to do to enter, just be a subscriber, leave a comment about Justice League on the video. Congratulations to the winner from the last video that I just did, Moon Man. Please private message me so I can get your contact details. I'll announce a winner the next time I post a Justice League video. But you can click here for my non-spoilery review, and you can click here for the brand new Flash trailer versus the Thinker in that Wonder Woman crossover scene. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.